IsSubtotal is a function that you can use inside Summarize to detect whether a row is a row coming from the scanning of your table or it is a specific subtotal as required by the rollup function. IsSubtotal is not used in Summarize columns because Summarize columns automatically adds columns that let you identify clearly which rows are subtotal and which are regular rows. Let's see that with an example. In this query, I'm using Summarize grouping. I'm summarizing product and I'm doing a rollup by product brand. Therefore, I will have not only the rows containing the product brand, but also the subtotal of all the brands. And then I create a column isSubtotal that uses the isSubtotal function on the product brand. This is true only when the row is a subtotal at the brand level. And you can see the result here. I have the three rows of the three brands which I have selected, which contain false for isSubtotal. And then I have a row that contains a blank for the brand. And isSubtotal is true, meaning that this is the subtotal at the brand level. Be reminded that you cannot check that the brand is blank, so the column brand contains a blank to verify that a row is a subtotal, because you might have a blank brand in the model and isSubtotal might still be false. So isSubtotal is useful in Summarize to check for the subtotal rows.